Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. This is a problem from the US Olympiad in 1993. Pause the video if you want to give this problem a go, and when you're ready, we'll go through the solution. To begin this problem, we'll first notice that since a and b are positive, a plus 1 must be greater than 1, and therefore since a to the power of n is greater than 1, it follows that a must be bigger than 1. This also implies that b plus 3a will be at least 3, and so b to the n will be at least root 3. And so likewise, we also know that b must be bigger than 1. Now, since we're dealing with b to the 2n, we might try and square a to the n. So we can write that a to the 2n is a plus 1 squared, or a squared plus 2a plus 1. And we can note that for all real numbers, a minus 1 squared will be greater than 0. And so expanding this and adding 3a, we show that a squared plus a plus 1 is greater than 3a. Now we can write the left side of this inequality as a to the 2n minus a, and the right side as b to the 2n minus b. And so we can write this as a to the 2n minus b to the 2n is greater than a minus b. Now, if a were to equal b, then we can realize that a to the 2n minus b to the 2n evaluates to 0, meaning that we know a minus b must be a factor. To generate the second polynomial, we can realize the first term must be a to the power of 2n minus 1, since that will produce a to the 2n. But that will also produce a minus b a to the power of 2n. And so we'll need to add ba to the power of 2n minus 2. But once more, that will produce a minus b squared a to the power of 2n minus 2. So to cancel that, we'll need to add in b squared times a to the 2n minus 3. And so now we can spot the pattern that this will continue all the way upwards until we arrive at b to the power of 2n minus 1. So now we arrive at the following inequality. If we take the a minus b on the right side and bring it to the left side, then we can factorize it as the following. Now notice that we began with a and b greater than 1, which means the sum of all these terms must themselves be greater than 1. And so this entire bracket must be greater than 0. And so it follows that a minus b itself must be greater than 0, and hence a is greater than b. And so we're done.